time because they have to come back to deal with bottom lane.
But look at the triumvirate of ward they placed around the Roche, but
they're trying to cancel these TPs. Damn, that damage is so fast to Kaka. They maybe they actually get this kill. KP's trying, but look at the damage reduction and the Echo Slam. They've got enough. The Ravage connects over on three. Maybe not when KP's able to begin his TP out. All they tried to do was hold him there. Oh, of course not. There is already a Yule Scepter over on the Razor. Triple kill for. The creeps are coming up through the rear as well. As the rock wall dissipates, Moon, he's battling in the tree lines so they can catch Kakar out once again, as well as Lich. They go for the supports, but now can they get the bigger ones? Can they kill off a core into Old 11 with a Requiem of Souls? Razor, well, he won't do that much damage. The TP's coming out. KP's on top of double kill, but does he have any more friends? When the Yorsim sends Moon up in the air, he's got no other choice but to stand here and fight against a 280 plus damage Razor, who is in the trees. Has he got enough? Moon working with Archit. It's just working through KP. How much damage have you got? Enough. And Moon feels very much like a worm on a bait. And now KP comes in. He's able to get, well, nothing off. In fact, he's able to get Kaperma stunned. Now he'll get his own badges. They're looking to focus over onto the Razor. Have they got enough damage? Not when Dark gives him the shields and Lycan into the back lines. Who are they really targeting on? Odolem's trying to get the front lines and now will actually use that damage. 250 damage, killing off his own Razor with a Requiem of Souls in the back lines. Lich is down, but Old Chicken's into the front lines. Mineski, they just want to disengage. The Ravage is still off cooldown. They could still use this. And he's going in deep. He'll actually let it go. He's looking for the kill with the swing. The plus 250. My lord. Moon is in so much trouble. The fissure. That voice off me speaking. Assassin is kind of trapped in the corner. Slaughter wants to battle him. They're baiting out the spine carapace. BKB from Moon allows him to hit in, but there goes your Ravage. Moon will be unaffected, but KP very affected. Down for 80 seconds. They really needed him. And here's your Spectral Horn. Back off cooldown with a full Abyssal Blade. They're ready to fight, and I think they're ready to win. This game looks like it's done and dusted. Lycan can move around to try and kill off Old Chicken, but with the fissure, it doesn't create enough space. They just go in deep, but the Echo Slam from Febby is stylish, but it ain't good enough. Old Chicken has a triple kill. They may give him more. GG is
pretty much a super creep at this point.
Yeah, it's a very good thing to keep in mind. The fact that KP wasn't there shows the fact that Mineski didn't want to fight. Kaka will force them into that engagement by killing off Ninja Boogie. While Moon bouncing around mid,
the tree.
He's cursed up, jumping over. Here's a third jump, and he'll drop down. He could move in time, and now Old Chicken gets the stun, doesn't connect on the Searing Chains. The Mud Golems will take that form, but Monkey King cannot get away. He's silenced up. This is going to be another plus two. Tries to dodge, hits him with a stun, but Kaka's got one better. The Spike Carapace is now plus six stolen intelligence for the silencer.
Look at this. They smoke, and immediately now look at KP. He's got his ultimate ready. But that Spirit Vessel, that regen rune.
Oh, the Searing Chains connect. This is a level 4 impale stun. KP will die so quickly. Spike Arm is available, but they know that the Spirit Vessel will get the kill, and they keep recharging.
They've got the grip. He's going to try and get it off, but he tanked the trap, and now he's just getting on top of one.
The Searing Chains, another trap will actually kill him because the Spirit Vessel's doing the work. Moon wants to jump in. He's around the back lines, but now King Gaming, with that one kill on the Bane field, they can go in a little bit deeper into the Morphling and the Global Silence, and the three-man, four-man Spike Carapace practically. Morphling will buy back into the game, but King Gaming, they want to end this so quick right now. If they can find a little bit more, I don't know how Mineski are meant to look at this. Monkey King is thinking about the Wukong command. He's actually going to follow through. A four-man stun. The buyback out from the Enigma. You've still got no black hole. The back in and the silence. King Gaming just want to start retreating back out once again. The TA is dead. And they keep their racks alive. Mineski getting a lot of money for this, but because they come out just once again, you think you have an advantage, but you have nothing. Moon, he'll go down. Another slide of fist through. Ninja Boogie, oh, they'll just take the Nightmare off, freeing up the cores to beat into the Bane. One by one, they keep dying and buying back. Top. Now they see the silencer. There's your opportunity, but he can't get close enough. The blink deck keeps getting put on cooldown, and the global silence being used. But the fact wall combination, way too good. Sideblade slice through everyone. Jump down south. You can kill the bounty hunter as well. And Mineski.